I'm Lori Beckman, Executive Editor of Products Finishing. We're here at Winona Powder Coating in Etna Green, Indiana.
Winona has built its 51-year-old legacy by evolving from a small job shop to a high-volume industrial coater. For more than 20 years, CEO Jamie Visker has led his team with a keen focus on problem-solving for customers, embracing cutting-edge powder coating technologies like UV and color-stable formulas, and developing techniques that deliver high-quality results that are changing the industries Winona serves. They've also added electrocoating to their capabilities, which has helped grow their customer base. This forward-thinking company leverages lessons learned to not only meet customer needs, but to elevate the industries they serve. The marine industry has especially been touched by Winona's powder coating expertise when it comes to coating pontoon boat railings. Check it out.
So we refer to this as line one. This is the line that originally we went into production with in 2013. When we started, we were in 170,000 feet with one line, and we thought, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do with all this space? And now we're out of space.
Okay.
This is the all aluminum line. Okay. But the reason you're seeing castings, these are automotive parts, is these are ecoat prime, so they don't go through the wash system.
Okay.
So what makes this an aluminum only line is the chemistry in the washer.
Okay.
It's so that we can get a more aggressive etch on the aluminum to get a better bond, where we can't do that same chemistry if we're running bimetal, if we're running steel, cast iron, and aluminum through this.
Okay.
So, but the parts that are ecoat prime can come through this line to get powder top coated.
Very shiny.
These are vehicle control arms. So it's what holds the wheel assembly onto the vehicle.
Okay, interesting. These are ecoated. Is that the ecoat?
This is ecoat powder top coat. So where you had a gloss finish, this is a separate, this is a different finish.
Okay.
So you've got a little bit of a texture on there.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
So these are dealer sold aftermarket parts for all-terrain vehicles. And then those will go somewhere to be either installed or packaged and shipped to the dealers. So you can see we've got boat rails coming through next. So here, the parts are exiting the washer into the dry-off oven, and then they'll get coated. You can see the level of quality inspection on these parts because they're exterior automotive. We'll package this online. So those are getting bagged prior to going into the returnable containerization. Dry-off oven, this is a manual boot that we only use on occasion if we're like doing an off-color or spray-to-waste. And then here's the automatic boot. This one's scheduled to be replaced this year.
Okay.
And then you'll see the new version across on line two.
Because it's old, you're just replacing?
Correct.
Okay.
And the efficiency gains are tremendous on the new one.
Okay.
And that's always a fun picture.
Yeah. So that's the curing after the powder coat cure.
Yep.
These have been cured.
Yep.
Okay.
So let's go over and look at line two,
okay,
which is the heavy parts line.
Okay.
And we can sort of show you that.
Okay.
So as you can see, some fairly heavyweight product on there. It's a fairly cool day. That's still warm.
Is it?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. It is. It'd be hot after a while, yeah.
So that gives you an idea of this line was designed to be able to give this enough time to get down here so we can package them.
Okay.
So if you'll notice the first difference, because this is the line two that we talked about that was put in for heavyweight, for heavier product, for castings.
Okay.
So one of the first differences that you'll notice is over on that line, you have the enclosed track conveyor. That's rated for 75 pounds every 8 inches.
Okay.
This is the I-beam conveyor, and this is 100 pounds every 6 or 200 pounds every 12 inches. So we can hang considerably more weight from this line.
Right.
So as we mentioned, much shorter wash on this line so that we can get product through. Since they're not long parts, we want to get product through and get it dried off.
How many parts go through every day?
Depending, it's
hard to know.
Some days it's tens of thousands of parts in a day. So we want to show you this is the brand new, this is the new booth we put in.
You see what they're doing? They put the masks on over here. And then they powder coat them.
Okay.
And then we take the masks out before they go in the oven so the mask doesn't stick to the part. So it's a very clean line.
The color will change, and I can have Matt explain this, but essentially what happens is with this booth can take a box of powder at a time. When he does the color change, they'll remove this. There's a blow down process where they'll clean all the guns and lines will clean out.
Okay.
And he can change the color. He can do a color change in about 10 minutes.
Okay.
So we don't stop the line. What they'll do is put about a 10 minute gap in the line, switch colors, and then he'll be ready for the next color when it gets here.
Okay.
One of the things about this booth. So this booth was the one installed in December of 2022. The efficiency gain on this booth versus the old technology, obviously we try to reclaim powder that gets blended back in with new, and that's how powder efficiency is done. But you don't use it all. So previously, we were landfilling about 12 Gaylord boxes, which is a skid size box, of waste powder a month. Those average about 1,500 pounds of powder.
Okay.
With the new booth, that number went from 12 boxes to 2 boxes. At 1,500 per box times 10 boxes, we're no longer, that are now that product is getting, that paint is on the part.
Yeah.
So the efficiency gain on that was tremendous.
Yeah. These are fixtures, you created the fixtures.
We do a lot of different racking so that we can get the best efficiency on the parts. This was the oven that we built. So this is the heavy duty oven.
Wow.
Once again, more marine parts with a ski toe.
Okay. Yeah, it's a little, like you said, not smooth. It has a little bit
of
a
It's a mini Tex.
Yeah, okay. This feels good. Not in the summer, I'm sure, but.
One of the best things about the powder coated product is once it exits the oven, it's a thermal cure process. So it is completely cured. So at this point, once we package it, it's ready for use in whatever, you know, industrial or commercial setting that it would go into.
Okay.
If somebody's doing a consistent, like one part all the time, a single part, you know, there can be, the automation will be robotic loading for brake rotors and things like that for say an internal line where the part geometry is always the same. You would go from a hand loading to a robotic loading.
Okay. But you don't do that.
We don't do that because of the variety of parts that come through here.
Yeah.
So this gives you just some scope as you see all this running down.
Yeah.
So limitations will be how fast can we hang it or package it?
Okay.
What kind of cure time does it need in the oven? That will always be a big one.
Yeah.
Because with powder, it's part temperature. So when we get a technical data sheet on a powder and it says, here's the cure window. And that cure window say is 350 degrees for 10 to 14 minutes. That's part temperature, not oven temperature.
Okay.
So we've got to get the part up to that temperature. So we've got to set the oven accordingly so that that part will be at its cure temperature for the requisite amount of time. It's amazing that this was such a successful project.
So cool, yeah.
It really is.
And so you said this is actually cooler to the touch once it's been outside in the sun.
It is. It's about 20 degrees cooler than a comparable black.
Okay.
In a smooth gloss finish.
Okay.
With a thermal camera, we were about 20 degrees cooler with this product in the Florida sun than the black powder coated or black anodized.
That's amazing.
Which the texture just diffuses the heat.
Yeah. Okay. Because you just think the color in general, black, would be hot.
Right.
Like no matter what, it would be hot.
It was amazing when I went up the first time to a boat sitting in our marina in Florida.
Yeah.
You know, I go up to one of the rental boats that's sitting up on, you know, they had it on a platform because they fork truck things in and around. I go up and I touch the rail, it's noon in the middle of summer, and the rail was warm, but it wasn't hot.
Yeah.
And the other reason this was successful was the customer, Smoker Craft, that we had in that original, you know, in the development. They were as willing as we were to put in the work to find a solution. So if you didn't have, if we hadn't had, you know, a customer willing to, you know, be a partner in this, I don't think we ever would have been successful. Should we go over to ecoat?
Yeah, sure. This whole area right here is all waste treatment. Our facility treats probably about 30 to 50,000 gallons a day of water, just from what our powder lines overflow, what ecoat overflows, draining of tanks, everything. So the coagulation, it's better done at a low pH. And then for the precipitation, that's at a high pH. Okay. And we're making the any of the solids in the water precipitate out.
So what kind of solids end up in the wastewater? Like metal?
Metals, dirt and grime, like off of the parts.
Okay.
This is what we want our clarifier to look like. And this looks excellent. Like no solids are coming up, no issues. So,
okay.
All right, so this is the start of the our eco line. So this was installed 5 years ago. What you're seeing right now are the parts exiting the machine. So the parts are loaded up and then it goes all the way down the line, up into the oven, goes all the way back across and then back down. Yes, these parts are finished. This part is for Ford. We are running a whole shift of these parts. Okay, so this is the start of our process. We have 13 tanks of just pre-treatment and 4 tanks that are associated with the painting process. This very first stage is a neutral descaler, so it does a really good job of cleaning around the weld areas of parts and really sharp edges and even a little bit of rust. So it's heated to about 140 degrees. And then the next two stages after this cleaning stage are just RO water rinses. So the parts will go into 2 and 3. At 3, we have a counter, we have a flow meter. So the water will actually counterflow from 3 to 2 and then go back out to waste treatment. Both of these tanks are exactly the same. The ZX6 is an alkaline cleaner. Alkaline cleaner can smut the parts. And we don't want those parts to be smutted. We keep that at a little bit lower temperature. 6 and 7 are both RO rinses as well.
So what does the conditioner do?
For substrates like steel, it will take all of the negative and positive charges that are on the part, and it makes them all positive for the next step. And then for steel, this is where the magic happens. This is our zinc phosphate tank. For aluminum, aluminum is basically just getting cleaned in this stage. For all the steel parts, they're going to see that zinc phosphate crystal structure form. 10 is just an RO rinse. So for steel, you have all of these crystal structures of the zinc phosphate. What the sealer does is if there's any like we call holes in the crystal structure on the part, the sealer will go in and it will fill in those holes. So 12 and 13 are also RO rinses. As soon as that lowers, now this light is on. So that means electricity is now being applied to the parts. Yep, yep. And then on our very last tank is just an RO rinse, because you can get what's called permeate drips on parts if that solvent is still on the part.
Okay. One of our employees took a TikTok of this.
Yeah.
It went viral. And within like no time, it was over 1 million views.
Really?
So this is cleaning racks. Because obviously whether it's e-coat or powder coat, you have to have the part grounded.
Okay.
Well, when you go to paint the part, you're gonna paint the rack. So rack cleaning is part of your quality procedures because you want clean racks to be able to, you know, to keep the ground on the part.
I never thought of that.
So This is a huge issue in powder coaters and e-coaters is rack maintenance and rack cleanliness for your ongoing production. Okay.